very much for inviting me. I'm the local NUT branch secretary in town. We've just had our branch meeting. I'm on the NUT national executive, and our union has supported the People's Assembly since the beginning. We've had someone on the steering committee and gave full support to the big event we had, and we're supporting the demonstration on Sunday at the Tory Party conference. I just want to say a little bit about some strike action that we're going to be involved in the next month or so, to say what that is about, and also to try and put it in the context of a wider campaign to defend education, you know, along the same lines as defending the NHS. But on October the 1st, and again on October the 17th, members of the two largest teacher unions, representing something like 85% of teachers, will be taking strike action in two halves of the country. So it's a national strike split into two halves, so covering 2 days. In London, it will take place on the 17th of October, Thursday the 17th of October, in London, the South East and the South West. And the reason for the strike action is because Michael Gove is essentially destroying the education system. The specific reasons for the action that we're involved in is that he has embarked on a project of deregulating teachers' pay and conditions of service. Rather than have any kind of national framework for pay and conditions, he wants 25,000 individual schools to set their own pay levels for teachers, to determine the rate at which teachers progress through any pay scales, and also to deregulate term dates, holiday dates, the length of the school day. And you can imagine the chaos that will cause for parents and for schools in local areas where, in town hamlets, if 100 different schools are setting their own term dates and holiday dates, and then next door in Hackney, where kids may have parents, they're doing something different depending on what they want as a school. So it's a real threat, both to the way in which teachers work, but we think into the way in which schools are organised locally through local councils and through local agreements. The deregulation of pay is a real threat because what it's about is driving down teachers' pay, making it harder for teachers to get pay rises, linking pay to performance, linking pay to people targets, people progress, and making them jump through more and more hoops to do that. So one other aspect of what he's doing is telling schools that they could save money by sacking support staff and getting teachers to do the jobs that they do. So don't employ people to do midday meal supervision, get teachers to do it instead. So it's an attack on everyone who works in a school, and that in a sense is what our action is about. But what we're trying to do and what we're trying to make clear is that our action, whilst technically is about defending our paying conditions, we want to win support for it by placing it in a wider context of defending education. Because as Rani and others have pointed out, that what Michael Gove is also doing is bringing in changes to what's taught in school, to the exam system, getting rid of the educational maintenance allowance, tripling tuition fees, to make it harder for some of our kids to get through school, to make it harder for some of our kids to get to university, making what they're taught very, very narrow, bringing back the old-fashioned style of exam system, which led to a few people passing and going to university, and lots of people failing and then not being able to get the jobs or the apprenticeships that they wanted. So it's a real attack on the system of education that we've had in this country for a long time. A couple of other things I want to say that is germane to this discussion, I think. You would think Secretary of State for Education oversees education in the country. One of the key jobs, you would think, would be to make sure that there are enough school places for children. It seems fairly straightforward, doesn't it? You know, we've got this number of children, they need that number of school places. There are currently a shortage building up in London of something like 120,000 school places will be needed in London in the next 3 years. And already in places down the road in Barking and Dagenham, they are having to put some children on half-week shifts. There are children literally coming in for half the week and then another group of children coming in for the second half of the week. Primarily because, I'm going to move away from that so it's annoying me. Primarily because Michael Gove won't let councils build the schools they need where they need them. He won't let local authority build local authority schools. If a local authority wants a new school, it has to be an academy or it has to be a free school. And we already know that the free schools that are springing up in Tower Hamlets are not being built where Tower Hamlets kids need them. So there's real pressure on school places at the moment that it's just going to grow and grow and grow unless Michael Gove does something about it and lets councils build the schools they need. There's also a growing shortage in the number of teachers. You'd think that would be the second job Michael Gove should have, to make sure there's enough teachers to put in front of the kids that there should be enough places for. But our evidence is showing that there are more and more, fewer and fewer applications to teach a training college than there were in the last few years. So there is a potential problem there. So we're trying to highlight that as part of what we do. All Michael Gove wants to do is to privatise education. That's what downsizing teachers' pay, that's what suppressing teachers' pay is about, is to soften schools up for privatisation. He wants 25,000 different schools run by 25,000 or maybe fewer than 25,000, but big private companies. And he has said he is relaxed about schools being run for profit. So that is where Michael Gove wants to take this, and we want to take it in a completely different direction, and we think we can do that by building public support for our strike action, but public support for a campaign to defend education. Now, Michael Gove, just give you two, what is he like? He wants to be the Tory party leader, and he has said he has declared war on the teacher unions, and he calls us the enemies of promise. This is the man who in Parliament, when they voted against the bombing of Syria, had to be physically restrained from attacking his own side, who had voted against the government, jabbing his finger at them, saying they turned their backs on the children of Syria and they were a disgrace, and had to be taken away, not by men in white coats, but had to be taken away from doing anything that might embarrass him. And then a week later, or 2 weeks later, when he was asked by a Labour MP about children in her constituency that can't afford school uniforms and whose families suffer the indignity of going to food banks, said, well, maybe they've made the wrong lifestyle choices. Maybe they've made bad decisions about how they spend their money. A really callous throwaway remark by a man who claimed £750 of our money for a dining room table in his London flat, and took advantage of free opera tickets at a cost of £800 each, four free tickets, £800 each. So he makes very clever financial decisions. He's very good at managing the money that comes his way, but a real contempt for the people that we've heard described, you know, by others in this meeting, to say poverty is a lifestyle choice and just the result of bad decisions. So we're determined to challenge Michael Gove. We're determined to challenge his attacks on pay and conditions, and we're determined to challenge him on his really reactionary proposals for education to turn it back to what he thinks is the golden age of the 1950s and 60s, but a golden age that we know never existed, was about education for the elite and not the many, which is what we want to see. So we've got 2 days of strike action in October, and there are plans by both unions to call a one-day national strike in November, and then possibly further action going into the autumn. It doesn't sound much when you say it, but it's more than either of our unions have ever done. So, you know, we're hoping to get support for it. We're busy building now, as I said, just come from a branch meeting, to make sure that members will take the action. Busy building support, we think, from parents. We're asking people to hold parents' meetings in school and meetings with support staff in school, so that we can develop this as a campaign, not just about teachers' pay and conditions, but a campaign about defending education. The last thing I will say, with the message we're trying to get out in the media, because we keep getting asked in the media, what's wrong with schools rewarding their best teachers? What's wrong with schools setting their own pay levels if they're working in different circumstances? And one simple thing we say about that is there is no company, even in the private sector, that lets all its institutions set their own pay. Sainsbury's, Tesco's, Vodafone, Barclays Bank, they don't let all their stores set their own individual pay for that store. They have a national framework for pay. and it changes if it's the cost of living's more expensive in London, but they have national pay systems. They may have systems for rewards and bonuses and overtime and extra work or promotion opportunities, but they don't have a system where the Sainsbury's here sets one pay different to the Sainsbury's in Waltham Forest or the Sainsbury's in Newham. So the idea that 25,000 schools should draw up their own policies, the idea that governors and head teachers should be distracted by that instead of the key task of education and focusing on teaching and learning, is one myth that we've got to crack, one myth that it's about raising standards, one myth that it's about improving education or improving teaching. There's nothing it will do, this system, to improve teaching and education. He's got it all wrong and can produce no evidence for it. So I hope you can find ways to support the action. I hope if your parents in schools, you'll talk to their teachers, your teachers, and say that you support the action. It does make a real difference, because people will be under attack. We will be under attack for ruining the education or making it inconvenient for parents. Parents always support us when we talk to them. We want to talk to parents, but if you're talking to parents, if you are parents, talk to your teachers, find out what you can do to support them, and come to the London demonstration on October the 17th. We're holding a demonstration in central London, marching to Downing Street, past Parliament, and to Michael Gove's offices. So a good route, very high profile, into the heart of government. We're hoping to get lots of media attention. If you're able to join us in whatever capacity you can join us, please do. We'll circulate the details. Thanks.